Hello everyone, I am Rasika from Final Year Section A. Our topic of discussion is IPv4 frame format. The Internet Protocol version 4 is the delivery mechanism used by the TCP or IP protocol. IPv4 is an unreliable and connectionless datagram protocol for best effort delivery support. The term best effort means that IPv4 provides no error control or flow control. IPv4 is also a connectionless protocol for a packet switching network that uses the datagram approach. This means that each datagram is handled independently and each datagram can follow a different route to the destination. This following diagram shows the IPv4 datagram frame format or protocol suite. Packets in the IPv4 layer are called datagrams. A datagram is a variable length packet consisting of two parts, header and data. The header is 20 to 60 bytes in length and contains information essential to routing and delivery. Each field of datagram format can be explained as follows. First is version. It is a 4-bit field defines the version of the IPv4 protocol. This field tells the IPv4 software running in the processing machine that the datagram has the format of version 4. All fields must be interpreted as specified in the fourth version of the protocol. If the machine is using some other version of IPv4, the datagram is discarded rather than interpreted incorrectly. Next is header length. This 4-bit field defines the total length of the header is variable when there are no options. The header length is 20 bytes and the value of this field is 5. When option field is at its maximum size, the value of field is 15. Next is services. IADF has changed the interpretation and name of this 8-bit field. This field was previously called service type and now it is called differentiated services. In this interpretation, the first 3 bits are precedence and the next 4 bits are called type of services, TOS bits, and the last bits are not bits. Both interpretations of services are shown in this figure. The first is service type. In this interpretation, the first 3 bits are called precedence bits and the next 4 bits are called type of service, TOS bits, and the last bits are not used. Precedence is a 3-bit subfield ranging from 0 to 7. The precedence defines the priority of the datagram in issues such as congestion. TOS bits is a 4-bit subfield with each bit having a special meaning. Although a bit can be either 0 or 1, one and only one of the bits can have the value of 1 in each datagram. The bit patterns and their interpretations are given in the table. We can have 5 different services. Second is differentiated services. In this interpretation, first 6 bits make up the code point subfield and the last 2 bits are not used. The code point subfield can be used in 2 different ways. When the 3 rightmost bits are zeros, the 3 leftmost bits are interpreted the same as the precedence bits in the service type interpretation. In other words, it is compatible with the old interpretation. Second is, when the 3 rightmost bits are not all zeros, the 6-bit defines 64 services based on the priority assignment by the internet or local authorities. According to the table, the first category is assigned by the internet authorities, the second category can be used by local authorities, and the third category is temporary and can be used for experimental purpose. Next is total length. This is in-bit field that defines the total length of the IPv4 datagram in bytes. To find the length of the data coming from the upper layer, subtract the header length from the total length. This is a formula given for the length of a data. So, other fields are related to the fragmentation. Identification flags, fragmentation offset, source IP address, destination IP address, time to life protocol, etc. First is identification. This 16-bit field identifies the datagram originating from the source host. The combination of the identification and source IPv4 address must uniquely define a datagram as it leaves the source host. To guarantee uniqueness, the IPv4 protocol uses a counter to label the datagrams. All fragments have the same identification number, the same as the original datagram. Next is flags. This field is used in fragmentation. This is 3-bit field. The first bit is reversed. The second bit is called the do not fragment bit. If its value is 1, the machine must not fragment the datagram. If it cannot pass the datagram through any available physical network, it discards the datagram and sends an ICMP error message to the source host. Next is checksum. The checksum in the IPv4 packet covers only the header, not the data. The implementation of the checksum in the IPv4 packet follows the same principles. First, the value of the checksum field is set to 0, then the entire header is divided into 16-bit sections and added together. The result as sum is complemented and inserted into the checksum field. Next is source IP address. This is a 32-bit field defines the IPv4 address of the source. This field must remain unchanged during the time the IPv4 datagram travels from the source host to the destination host. Next is destination address. This 32-bit field defines IPv4 address of destination. This field must remain unchanged during the time IPv4 datagram travels from the source host to the destination. Next is options. The header of the IPv4 datagram is made up of two parts, a fixed part and the variable part. The fixed part is 20 bytes long and was discussed in the previous section. The variable part comprises the options that can be maximum of 40 bytes. Options, as the name implies, are not required for a datagram. They can be used for network testing and debugging. Options can be single byte or multi-byte. Single byte options contain no operation and end of operation. So, no operation option is a single byte option used as a filter between options, and the end of option, it is also a single byte option used for padding at the end of the option field. Multibyte contains record root, strict source root, loose source root, timestamp. Record root. It is used to record the internet routers that handle the datagram. It can be used for debugging and management purpose. Strict source root. It is used by the source to predetermine a route for the datagram as it travels through the internet. If the datagram specifies a strict source route, all the routers defined in the option must be visited by the datagram. Loose source route. It is similar to the strict source route. Each router in the list must be visited, but the datagram can visit other routers as well. Timestamp. It is used to record the time of the datagram processing by a router. The time is expressed in milliseconds from midnight. We can estimate the time it takes for a datagram to go from the router to another router. Estimate means all routers may use universal time. Their local clocks may not be synchronized. This is all about the options and IPv4 frame format. Thank you.